make sure our phone's on mute.
Yeah, it's on mute.
You sure that's gonna be good for you? Like the angular?
Yes.
Just okay, for sure. Are you all set?
Hey, SWAT chief from Pundit. SWAT chief from Pundit.
One time, if you're a bad bitch. One time. Just for the savage. All you wanna do is just slay. Yeah. All you wanna do is just slay. Just slay. All you wanna do is just slay. Oh. All you wanna do is just slay. Whoop. Just slay.
Now, the headset's going on. These headsets have to, you'll be aware of things going on, okay? You will be. So the headset's going to make sure to adjust the sound and everything adjusted. You can do it here. Good morning. It's the Tony Chat. Your host, Andrew Moore. Welcome to another hot July day. Thank each one of you for listening. I see in the grocery stores. In fact, I saw one of my classmates at Publix last week, and he said, listen to the show. I really appreciate each and every one of you. And before we get started today, let's go ahead and do an inspirational moment with Pastor Ivy Will. Pastor, are you there? Pastor? Each one of you in the stores all the time, and you say, listen, thank each and every one of you for your listenership. I do truly appreciate it. Pastor, are you there? I do truly appreciate it. Before we get started today, I need to do this. One of my dearest friends and fraternity brothers passed away a couple weeks ago. He was a coach here in the area at Warren Beach Elementary School, and Father Lopez and Bethune Cookman, assistant basketball coach, and a valued member of our community, Mr. Morris Small. Known Mr. Small for a very long time. His mother actually was the head of the education department at Bethune Cookman, Dr. Florence Rome. And Morris will be greatly missed. Sympathies and go out to his family, Kirtland, and, Wayne, and Bernard. We all a heavy heart for each one of you. All right, Pastor, are you there? Down the end of Mason Avenue. Police department is right there at the end, the left-hand side. That is the new location of the police department here in Daytona Beach. Oh, wow. Everyone's going to meet at Joe Harris Park. That's right there on River Cloud Bethune Boulevard. Join the city code department officer for a code walk at 10:30 a.m. Wednesday. This is a future date, September the 4th. Code walks are a great way to learn about the code enforcement process as we walk together to identify and address code issues one neighborhood at a time. They're going to meet at Joe Harris Park, in fact, more commonly on Harlem Park, located at 315 Pearl Street, and go through the area of Dr. Mary McAuliffe Boulevard from Martin Luther King Jr. to Ridgewood. This is going to begin September the 4th. I'll read this again next week. It's called a code walk. And you're going to start at Dr. Martin Luther King Jr. Boulevard and walk to Ridgewood Avenue. Very intelligent young ladies here with us today who are going to talk about their actual experiences and what they gained from this very, very program. A couple weeks ago, we had Mrs. Rikini Henson on, and she told us about pretty ladies. Now we actually have some pretty ladies sitting right here in front of me today. And we're going to talk about their involvement in this wonderful mentoring program. And first of all, I'm going to let them introduce themselves and hope they tell us a little bit about who they are, where they came, what schools they graduated from, what grades they're in, and anything else like sheriffs. We'll start over here with Lady in the red shirt. Your name is?
My name is Lakin.
Lakin, yes.
And I graduated from Maine, class of 2019.
Go Bucks, go ahead.
And I plan on studying at FAMU.
Uh-oh.
But I have to do 2 years for my associate's at DSC, Daytona State.
So you're going to be a reptile on the stage.
She's going to be a rattler.
I didn't say anything about it.
She's going to be a rattler.
In fact, I didn't even look at this end of the We'll move on. Yes, ma'am. Your name is?
Jariah.
And what can you tell us? What grade are you in, Jariah?
I'm going to the ninth.
You're going to ninth grade. What school are you attending?
Mainland
High School. And what is your career ambition? What do you plan to be? What's your career?
Physical therapist.
Oh, good. Girl, look, I got a pain over here. Berkeley, okay. And finally, your name is?
My name is Maya.
Maya, and Maya, you just graduated, understand, is that correct?
Yes, I just graduated from Pace Center for Girls.
Fantastic. Fantastic. And you've been here in Daytona Beach all your life, correct?
No, I actually recently just moved here about 4 or 5 years ago from up north, Boston, Massachusetts.
Oh, it's cool up there.
Very.
And again, we have our, I guess it would be director.
Yes, sir.
Founder.
Yes.
Coordinator.
All of the above.
Ms. Rakeen Henson.
Yes, sir. Name.
Ms. Henson, can you identify yourself a little bit about you before we start?
I'm Rakeen Henson. I'm the founder and also the director for Pretty Ladies. And Pretty is an acronym, stands for Preparing Responsible, Educated, Talented, Tenacious Young Ladies.
Wow.
It's a mentoring program for middle and high school girls.
Let's go to is a role model, is that true or no?
Yes.
That's very good. Lakeland, why? Why are you excited to join the program?
I decided to join the program because it gives me a better understanding from other girls' perspectives and how they, you know, do different things. It helps me to build different bonds between other children out the house.
I think it's an excellent point there. You see how other girls do things too. You'd be surprised how people think exactly the way you do and do things exactly the same way you do. And it's good to know that other people have shared that same process and do the same thing. That was an excellent answer, I think. I think girls are, a lot of people realize that once you get involved with the groups, things like that. That's an excellent answer. And why did you decide to join the program?
I decided to start the program to get out of the house and to better myself, to start hanging around better influences and just give me the extra help that I needed to figure out how to do things the right way.
Fantastic. Let me ask you this. How significant is peer pressure? I mean, your classmates, let me remember that. The people you go to school with, the people you're friends with.
Peer pressure really started once I started high school.
True.
I started at Mainland High School. I wasn't hanging around the right people. Peer pressure took over and I just started not doing so great. So then I started at Pace Center for Girls. I heard about the program. I started, and it really just gave me a second chance.
Okay. Let me continue this peer pressure. The internet. Everything on the internet is true, right?
Yeah.
No, it's not. And a lot of us, you spend time on the internet, you guys play video games, things like this too. In fact, I'm going off on a tangent, I'll be back. This young man just yesterday won $3 million playing a video game. Fortnite, what is it? I don't even know what that is. You know, $3 million, so I'm gonna start playing video games today. But anyway, So that's also, when I was growing up, the most influence we had was looking at magazines, looking at pictures. And those couple years ago, looking at pictures in the magazine. But you guys got the internet, all kinds of distractions. We got television now. We had television. It was invented when I was young too, okay? There was television there, you got the radio. These words, the lyrics in the radio, the songs they sing, the words they say, you know, that those are all kind of influences that affect you and can affect you in positive and sometimes negative ways. So you girls have stepped above that now. You're talking interaction with other people. That's something a foreign, you know, people don't write letters anymore. Mm-hmm. They text, they email. What's your most about it from that? What was your interaction?
I enjoyed having fun, laughing more, smiling more. And being around positive vibes.
Okay. And what about you?
I enjoy like
when guests come and talk to us about like what they experienced and like our age or like older. And I enjoy
communicating with other girls
and like.
Yeah, she was the most nervous when we started the program, but she was fantastic. And what about you?
I mostly just enjoy being able to talk about things and I just kind of use it as a support group. The program's good to talk about things and just get everything out and enjoy being out of the house.
Well, Ms. Henson, we talked about it last time you're here, but let's familiarize ourselves, our audience, with how this actual program initiated, how it started. And what gave the emphasis to start the actual program here?
Well, the program started several years ago. A friend of mine actually asked me to do some focus groups. But coming out of it for me was the lack of information that high schoolers had. They just didn't have good, solid information.
The other word, sex, the other words. sex.
Just pass it along. So from that conversation, I said, she said to me, well, why don't you start a group? And I was like, well, who wants to listen to me? And she was like, you should start a group. And from there, I started, we started with middle schoolers at the time, and then it evolved to include high schoolers as well. But just like the girls have explained, it's an outlet to be able to release some of that energy, but also to get some guidance. You know, a lot of times there's things that we will say to other students or some things that they might be comfortable saying to me that they may not be able to say at home for a variety of reasons. So we have that adult that's still going to give them good guidance, but they also have their peers to rely on as well.
I see, but why would you tell your friend to come to this program?
I would tell my friends to come to this program because just like it helped me, it can help them, mm-hmm. and it can give a better aspect of, you know, life and what you need to do with getting yourself together other than being on the phone and being home, doing anything, nothing. So that would be what I would tell people.
Wow, very good answer, because I'm thinking at your age, just those, you mentioned all the things they do at your age, the telephone and things like this. This is very good. So as a young, we're just getting to be a teenager here, right? 13, 14. Well, why would you tell those people to come join this program?
Because my family, they don't have like a very good mindset. So like, if they come in this program, they'll have a better mindset than what they used to have. Mm-hmm. And it will get them out of the house and like,
they can
be a better person.
Well, let me ask this. How important is goal setting to establish goals? Is this something you guys do, sort of goals, short range, short, long-term goals? But what are some of your short-term goals? Yes? No? Okay. All right, who has a short-term goal? You told me you want, what is your career aspiration? Oh, a short-term goal then.
Okay, short-term goals is to get myself together and learn how to not be so locked in. And, you know, my parents, they'll protect me, my grandparents, so I want to go out and better myself and learn in ways where I can go out and do better than they did.
Listen to this. You know who the very first teacher each one of you had? Anybody know the very first teacher you had? Your parents. Or your grandparents. Those are the very first teacher you had. Some of the things you do now, you know why you do them, but guess what? They were embedded in you because they taught you those things. So we look in the mirror 20 years ago from now and look back, your mother, mom, or dad looking at you, guess what, you're just like it. This is the question I asked, you know, you gotta laugh, so I gotta do it now. Listen to this. What type of issues are most pressing for students of your age? The most pressing, the most severe, the most, okay, go ahead.
Getting exposed and having boyfriends.
Getting exposed, you gotta define exposed, what does that mean?
Having to do with cyber.
Oh, okay, right.
On the internet.
And have a boyfriend.
Yes. And the other word, sex.
And you? we'll hear that. And we'll come over here to you now. I have two daughters to you.
Your mind thought and your
just openness about it. And I know a certain place I can't go, but those things I can't go, but those anyway. Thank you again for being on the chat. Remember, if you have any comments, like to be on the show, and suggestions, you can do that by emailing me here at DaytonaChat@gmail.com. Any questions for the ladies here, you can email those too. I'll make sure to get them to get the questions to them. Thank you to all those listening. Tune in, those listening to the website, those listening to the broadcast. Hey,
SWAT Chief 400.
One time, if you're a bad bitch. One time. Two times, just for the savage. All you wanna do is just slay. Yeah. All you wanna do is just slay. Just slay. All you wanna do is just slay. Oh. All you wanna do is just slay. Whoop, just say.